Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Area under curve is the most common way to quantify drug exposure. Let's see how to determine AUC for an IV bolus. To determine AUC for an IV bolus, we need to go through several steps, most of which we have seen in previous videos. We need a table of natural log CP time data points. Next, we'll determine the KEL of our molecule. The slope of the natural log CP time line is minus KEL. Three, we'll estimate CP naught. The y-intercept for our line is natural log CP naught. Fourth, we'll add this new data point to our data set. That's the data point for zero natural log CP naught. And then the final step, we'll use the trapezoid method on the CP time curve to estimate the area under curve, the AUC. This last step is the new one. Here is our table of natural log CP time data points. You'd normally have more than three data points, but three data points will keep our calculations simple. From these data, we can get minus KEL with the slope function. We can also get natural log CP naught through the intercept function. That gives us a fourth data point for our y-intercept. Time zero and natural log CP equals 2.30. Let's finish this with the trapezoid approximation to get AUC, area under curve. Here is a table with our CP time points with a graph. Note that we now have 4 points, and this is CP, not natural log CP. The trapezoid approximation estimates each region between the points as a trapezoid. The area for each trapezoid is the average value of the bounding points multiplied by this time interval between the points. Here are the area calculations for each trapezoid. Note that this line does continue, and there's more area under the curve. It even extends beyond the graph that we've drawn. How do we handle this last area? It's not a trapezoid. The area for this final region, area last, can be determined from the last CP value, creatively called CP last, and KEL, which we determined on the last slide. Okay, add up these areas, the bottom of the screen, and you have the AUC for this IV bolus dose. I haven't been careful with units. Let's assume that the units on CP are micrograms per milliliter. The units on AUC would be microgram hours per milliliter. AUC is an indication of drug exposure, an important idea for drug safety and efficacy. AUC calculations like this one are also critical for determination of other pharmacokinetic parameters, which we will see in later videos. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, like, or leave a comment. If you have questions about all this math, please leave a question or comment. Take care.